we're gathered here today to mourn yet another brilliant one of our companions. It had a compelling call to action, a beautiful subject line, yet it never reached its destination.
Getting tired of your emails getting buried in the spam folder? Let's make sure your next campaign doesn't end up like this. Deliverability is the most overlooked part of outbound. You can write the perfect message, target the right people, and time it just right. But if it lands in spam, it's like it was never sent. It doesn't exist. And it's only gotten harder. In the last 2 years, Google and Microsoft have rolled out strict new rules. Send too many emails? Spam. Use the wrong words? Spam. Include a link or an image? Spam. So, is deliverability dead? Not even close. If you follow the right steps, not only will you reach the inbox, you'll outperform everybody who doesn't. What feels like 2025's biggest curse might actually be your biggest edge. In this video, I'll show you the full 11-step methodology to make sure your emails never land in spam again. From technical setup to warm-up, copywriting, and sending email limits, this is everything you need to get it right. First, use multiple domains and inboxes. The most scalable and reliable way to run mass cold email campaigns is simple. Use multiple domains and inboxes. This is called inbox rotation, because if you rely on just one domain, you're putting its reputation at risk. And no matter how good your campaigns are, some emails will be marked as spam. When that happens, deliverability drops, not just for cold emails, but for everything else sent from that domain. Now you see, with inbox rotation, you spread out the risk. Let's say your main domain is salesforce.com. This domain has strong SEO, high authority, and great sender reputation. To protect it, you'd run cold emails through satellite domains like gosalesforce.com or trysalesforce.com, for example. Each domain could have several inboxes like rafael@gosalesforce.com and rafa.n@gosalesforce.com. If one inbox gets flagged, the others keep working and your main domain stays untouched. Second, buy cold email domains from high-quality sources. If you're doing cold outreach, you need more than just one domain, but not all domains are equal. Where you buy them and what you buy matters. Buy from the wrong source and you're setting yourself up for technical pain. So here's what to do. Buy from top-tier providers like Google or GoDaddy. Avoid Namecheap and similar low-end platforms. Stick to clean on-brand names. Use your company name and the simple prefix like go, try, get, or a suffix like HQ or email. No numbers, no symbols, no hyphens. And unless it makes sense for your industry, don't stray from .com. If you're in tech, domains like .ai or .tech are fine. Otherwise, keep it classic. Once bought, connect these domains to your Google or Outlook admin accounts. And if you want to skip the setup, on Lemlist, you can buy secondary domains and inboxes already connected to Gmail or SMTP. Our pleasure. So you're ready to start sending right away. Third, you set up MX, DKIM, SPF, and DMARC records. Now, all of these acronyms sound technical, but they're not optional. They're the backbone of email authentication. Without these records, email providers have no reason to trust you. You could write the perfect cold email and still end up in spam, because if your domain isn't authenticated, you look like a fake sender, even when you're not. The good news? They're easy to set up. Just Google how to set up a DMARC record plus your domain provider and follow the guide. If you bought your domain and inboxes from the same place, like a Google domain with Google Workspace inboxes, MX, DKIM, and SPF are set up automatically. You just need to add DMARC. Before you start sending, you can use this Lemlist free tool to check everything's correctly in place. Quick breakdown if you're curious. So MX tells where emails for your domain should be delivered. DKIM verifies your messages using cryptographic signatures. SPF checks if the sending server is allowed to send on your domain's behalf. And finally, DMARC ties it all together and tells providers what to do if checks fail. By the way, this is how I do 4. And if you'd rather skip the setup, well, on Lemlist, when you buy an inbox, all of this is already done for you. Same price, but zero tech hassle. Fourth, set up a custom tracking domain. Open rates tell you if your emails are reaching the inbox or the spam folder. It's one of the first signals to track when launching a cold email campaign. Most platforms track opens using a small invisible pixel inside each email. But here's the problem. If you're using a shared tracking domain, you're also sharing its reputation, meaning your emails could get flagged because someone else used the same pixel for spam. Using public tracking domains, like the ones from HubSpot, can tank your deliverability. All it takes is a few bad actors using the same pixel and you're in trouble. That's why you should always set up your own custom tracking domain. It lets you monitor open rates without being affected by other senders' behavior. Now, depending on the sales engagement platform you're using, the process can differ. Here's how to do it in Lemlist, for example. even easier if you purchase an inbox directly from Lemlist. The custom tracking domain is already set up for you. Fifth, set up the right number of inboxes. There's no mystery to how many domains and inboxes you need. It's just math. If you send too many emails from too few inboxes, your chances of hitting spam go way up. And if something goes wrong with one inbox, you've got nowhere else to pivot. You end up stuck. So here's a simple rule of thumb. No more than 50 emails per inbox per day. If you really want to avoid all kinds of problems, get down to 30. 2 to 3 inboxes per domain, 3 to 4 domains per admin console or tracking account. To figure out what you need, take your daily email target and divide it by 50. That's your inbox count. Divide again by 100 and you've got your domain count. Always build in some breathing room. Aim for 20% more than your minimum. That extra capacity gives you flexibility to pause or swap out inboxes if needed, without stopping your outreach. So, if you plan to send 200 emails per day, don't stop at 4 inboxes on 2 domains. Set up 5 inboxes, maybe even 6. It's a small step that keeps everything running smoothly. Sixth, warm up your inboxes. Just set up a new domain. Hold on. Before sending anything, you have to warm up your inbox. If you send too many cold emails from a fresh domain, email providers flag you as suspicious. You're unknown. Your volume is high. You look like spam. The result? Your emails skip the inbox and land in spam from day one. Inbox warming helps build a solid reputation gradually. Start small. 5 emails per day on one and increase by 5 each day until you hit 50 per day. Stick to 3-week warm-ups. When we extend our warm-up from 2 weeks to 3, open rates jumped 30%. With Lemlist, it's all automated through Lemwarm. It sends emails from your new domain to verified inboxes, builds engagement, and increases volume over time safely. So don't rush. Go make yourself a nice warm cup of coffee. Take a break, your email's warming up. Once your campaign starts, don't turn warming off. Keep it running. Just dial it down to 10 to 15 warm-up emails per day. Why? Because if you send 50 cold emails a day and get 0 replies, providers will take notice and not in a good way. But if replies come in steadily, you're good. Seventh, nail your copywriting. Great deliverability starts with technical setup, but copy is what gets people to open and reply. You can have the best domain, warmed inbox, perfect DNS records, but if your email sounds generic or relevant, you will not get results. We've sent emails from fresh inboxes with no warm-up and still hit 70% open rate because the message was tailored, personal, and worth opening. Write like a human. Use a compelling offer, 3 personalized lines, and a clear, easy-to-answer call to action. Certain words instantly raise red flags for spam filters. Mention things like Jesus, Bitcoin, or Viagra, and you're asking for trouble. Always review your subject lines and email content to avoid common spam trigger terms. On Lemlist, there's a built-in spam checker for every email you write. If your score goes above 5, your email is likely to be flagged as spam. Additionally, send from someone who's known and trusted. Start with a person in your company who has the strongest online presence. If not possible, send from the founder. If not the founder, choose a public-facing role like the CMO or VP of sales. And if all else fails, use a female sender name. Listen, it improves response rates more often than not. It's just a fact. Pro tips. Want to boost open rates? Use personalized subject lines for each prospect. They increase opens by 32%. Eighth, do not use images or links in cold emails. Cold emails work best when they look like something you'd send to a colleague. Simple, plain text, straight to the point. Images and links send the opposite signal. Images often get blocked by email clients. Links are red flags for spam filters. Add either and you're more likely to get flagged or blocked before your message is even seen. Stick to plain text. It keeps your email clean, simple, and focused, so the content has to do the work. No images, no links, no distractions. Now, about unsubscribes. Some places like Europe or California require an opt-out option in cold emails, but unsubscribe links come with a trade-off. They're links, so bad for deliverability. They look automated and they will tell filters you're running a bulk sequence. Instead, try this. Use a line like, "If this isn't relevant, just let me know." It lets people opt out without clicking and keeps your email looking personal. Remember, you only get a few seconds to stand out in the inbox. Make every word count. And to make sure your prospect sees your message, because that's what matters the most at the end of the day, go multi-channel. With LinkedIn, you're sure your email gets delivered. Ninth, use AI to personalize and write every message as a different one. The easiest way to land in spam is to send the same cold email over and over again. Email providers are built to detect patterns and they do not like identical ones. If your messages all look the same, they'll get flagged as mass outreach. Even if your offer is solid, even if your setup is perfect, axed. You'll still end up in the promotions tab or worse, in the dreaded spam folder. AI solves this fast. Use it to rewrite each message with a slight variation. Different intros, different phrasing, even different sentence structures. And make sure every email has at least one personalized line that proves it was written for that lead. At scale, this would take hours by hand. With AI, it takes literally seconds. And it makes every message feel like a one-off, not part of a sequence. Let me show you how it works. You click here, you add a prompt. Let's say we want to personalize the icebreaker based on their job title. Click on generate, and we're done. Because the truth is, inboxes don't block cold emails. They block lazy ones. 10th, send only to valid email addresses. Before sending any cold email campaign, there's one non-negotiable step. Clean your list. Sending emails to invalid addresses leads to bounces, and bounces damage your domain's reputation fast. Even a few can hurt your deliverability across the board. If your bounce rate hits 5%, stop your campaign immediately and recheck every email. Use tools like Zero Bounce or Bouncer to clean your list. Zero Bounce is the most reliable and the most expensive. Bouncer works well and costs less, so you have options. On Nemlist, you get verified emails already checked by both top providers, so you can skip the cleanup step entirely. Also, avoid catch-all domains. These accept all incoming mail, so they don't confirm if an address actually exists, which means you're guessing and risking bounces. Keep your bounce rate under 2% to stay safe. Between 2 and 5%, that's your warning, something's up. And over 5%, stop everything ASAP and fix your list. Last but most definitely not least, 11th, make sure your message actually lands with follow-ups and multi-channel. Sometimes, your cold email doesn't get ignored because it's bad. It gets ignored because it's buried. Your prospect might get 100 plus emails a day. Even if yours is well-written, personalized, and relevant, they might just miss it. Or open it, mean to reply, and forget. It happens. If you stop after one email, you're not giving yourself a real chance. So, follow up. Most replies don't come from the first email, they come from the second, third, or fourth. And don't stop at email, reach out on LinkedIn. If you have their number, pick up the phone. When your message shows up in more than one place, it's harder to ignore. Sometimes it's not about changing what you say, it's about making sure they actually see it. Now that you've got everything you need to master cold email deliverability, the simplest way to know if things are working is to check your open rates. If it's below 40%, then you've got deliverability issues. Unsure? Use this free tool to find out. And if you apply the 11 steps we covered, your open rate should never drop below 60%. So let's recap. Deliverability is a lot of things. You have a technical setup, you need an email warm-up, you have to optimize your copywriting with AI to gain time, you send only to verified email addresses, and finally, you send a limited number of emails per sending emails using inbox rotation. If you're serious about outbound, you already know where to go. And if you want to see how to write AI-powered cold emails that not only get opened but also get positive replies, then check out this video right here. Peace.